it's the start of a new year. We're all trying different things. We have goals, we have resolutions, and maybe one of your goals for 2020 is to learn to bake, or maybe your goal is to eat a little bit healthier. In either event, I have you covered, so make sure that you stick around for today's video. I'm Patty, and welcome to my handmade lifestyle. I get by Patty Mac Makes everywhere online. We're all about celebrating that analog life in this crazy digital world. If that sounds good to you, then I invite you to like today's video and subscribe to the channel and hang out with us. It's fun here and you will learn some cool stuff. It's the new year and most of us make all sorts of plans for the new year, all these things that we're going to do differently, we're going to do better, yada, yada, yada. Today's video, we're going to try to hit on both of that learning to bake goal and eat a little bit better goal in one fell swoop. And we're doing this because we're going to make, and the box is already open, I'll just tell you. I'm going to make this mix from Food Stars. Okay, without further delay, let's jump into today's video and I'll show you how to mix these up and then we'll give them a try and see what we've got. Okay, let's jump in. I have the oven preheating to 350 degrees and I've got all of my ingredients ready to go. And you can see that the main thing we're going to use today is this Food Stars organic protein bar mix, and I got it in the chocolate chippy sea salt. I just thought that looked really good. These mixes don't have any additives or any non-organic ingredients, and Sarah Michelle Gellar from Buffy, if you're a Buffy fan, from what I can tell, like, this is her company, so she really wanted things that she could make with her children, and a mix is a really great thing to have with kids because they can pretty easily follow the instructions and be successful in their baking. So this is a really good way to get people into the kitchen. The instructions are pretty easy to follow. The recipe itself will make 8 bars and they bake for 15 minutes. So what we're going to use for this is you will need the Food Stars mix. And in this case, we're using that chocolate chippy sea salt protein bar. So you'll need one of these mixes. You're also going to need 3/4 cup of milk and 1/4 cup of oil. And this is 4 ounces of chocolate chips. I had these left over from my Christmas baking and I thought I would just go ahead and throw them in there and use them up. The recipe calls for using regular milk. I have buttermilk. I really like buttermilk in my baking, so that's what I have here. And this recipe called for melted coconut oil. I have grapeseed oil, which is a, what they call, like, non-flavored oil. So that's what I'm using here. I like to use what I have on hand. And I had that and it was opened, so that's what I'm using. Any sort of mild flavored oil is going to work. So a canola oil would work. What you don't want to do is you don't want to use like an olive oil or something heavy. But canola or vegetable oil is going to be fine. And the chocolate chips are optional. You don't have to do this. I just, you know, I always like to just be a little bit extra. What can I say? And then let me just swing around over here. This is the pan. And it calls for an 8x8 baking pan. And that's what this looks like. It's kind of, it can be a little bit tricky to find that size pan. A lot of things are written for 9x9. But if you do go ahead and get the 8x8, you will use it, I promise. There's a lot of different recipes written for that, but the 9x9 is more common. This I got as a set from HSN. It's part of the Love and Daisies brand, and I have really liked her bakeware. This is parchment paper, and what I did was I just cut the parchment to go in, and then when the bars are done, I can just lift them out. So So I have buttered the entire pan and put the parchment over top. So we'll mix everything and we'll pour it in right on top of this paper and then bake it that way. And then when it's done and cooled, I can just lift it out easily, and that will help me with cutting nice even strips. Okay, let's get it mixed. The instructions for making these protein bars could not be easier. Really, all you're going to do is to combine the wet ingredients with the dry ingredients that are in the package, mix until combined, and pour that into your prepared pan. Then you're going to bake at 350. You want to make sure that your oven is preheated and ready to go. And we're going to bake on the middle rack of the oven for 15 minutes. Check at 15 minutes, make sure that the bars are firm. If they're firm, then they're done. So that is the whole thing. Baking these protein bars for about 17 minutes. I didn't feel like they were quite done in my oven at 15, so I went with 17. You'll just need to keep an eye on them because everybody's oven is a little bit different. So just check them at 15 and you can just lightly touch them. If they feel firm to the touch, they're done. If they're not quite firm, give them another minute or two. First impressions are that they look and they smell amazing. I mean, really. They look like brownies, honestly. They look really, really good. And I've already tried them, and I'll tell you, they are really good. They're not a brownie. So if you're expecting this to be like eating a full fat, high sugar brownie, you're gonna be disappointed. It is not like that, but it's still really good. And one of these bars will have 12 grams of protein in it, which I think is just really good. So do I recommend them? Yes, definitely. They're really good. I definitely think you should make them for yourself and try them out and see what you think, because we all like different things. I like them. I would buy and make these again. Definitely add the chocolate on top. That made a bit of a difference for me. And it didn't add that many extra calories because it was only 4 ounces spread across like 16 servings. So that's not too bad. That's the video for today. I really hope you enjoyed it. I hope that it helps you to try something new, give healthy eating and baking a try in the new year. And I think you're gonna be surprised at how much you enjoy it. Okay, that's it. Until next time, I'll see you in the next video.